Our team coverage continues new at 6 tonight. As Heather mentioned, one of the victims' families came to court to hear from Pavone. The Carter family was there.
That's right. News Channel 5's Gabrielle Komorowski spoke to Tim Carter's son before the court appearance. Gabby, how's that family doing?
Well, you guys, when I interviewed the Carter family on Wednesday, they were beyond devastated. The mood in the room was incredibly tense. But today, even though they're mourning, there was also a strong sense of relief.
As one of my cousins put it, that was the best six o'clock wake-up call that we ever had.
Not even 24 hours after laying his father, Tim, to rest, Brian Carter says the phone call he received early Friday morning made him feel something he hadn't felt in days.
I was just happy. You know, I can't say it any other way.
For nearly a week, Tim Carter's brothers, sisters, and his mother have been keeping close inside a family member's Plattsburg home. The large family has been comforting each other while mourning the untimely death of their beloved family member.
This really helps with the closure for the family.
After days of searching for the man police were calling their prime suspect in the deaths of Tim Carter and Patricia Howard, Anthony Pavone was arrested near Binghamton.
We're thankful for, you know, the New York State Police and all the police agencies that were out there, you know, helping find this guy.
Carter takes comfort in the fact that the man police say took the life of his father is no longer on the run.
I hope he gets what he deserves. I hope the punishment fits the crime, and we can't wait for justice to be served.
Now, as we mentioned, Tim Carter's funeral was yesterday, and his family says hundreds attended the service in Dannemora. Services for Patricia Howard were held today. Back to you guys.